out here in New York City, but we're still having fun in
supposed
the studio.
To, supposed to be sunshine whenever Molly's around. That's what it's supposed to
Listen,
be.
Listen, you said it, not me.
All right,
coming to you from above the Heineken River deck at Pier 17. Stephen A. is a little bitter, but Stephen A., you got something else for us?
Oh, yeah.
Put a smile on our face?
Real quick. Okay. There was some stuff last night, Jay Williams, Keyshawn Johnson. Look at Lori Walker. There is a sign that he is still with the Chicago Bulls. Look at that right there. That was a nice dunk by that brother right there.
I'm
sorry. Yeah,
he's a cat. Now I'm sorry. I forgot he left the Bulls. Look at that. And look at this dunk right here by Brandon Ingram on Anthony Edwards. Look at that right there, Brandon Ingram. Ooh, that was a nice dunk. Nice dunk, but that's why it's top five. It's not top three. Here's a top three one right here. It's Anthony Edwards. Look at that.
Ooh.
That's Anthony Edwards right there. Look at that brother right there. Something special. Too. Some people felt he should have been a rookie of the year. I think it should have been co-rookie of the year with him and LaMelo myself. But nevertheless, that was look at number 2 on the list. Look at this dunk right here. That's one dunk by John Collins, okay? Look at that nasty one. But check out the other one that's about to come right here. Check out this dude, Jay Wood. Look at this.
Climb on his back. Climb on his back.
Oh, that was nasty right here.
What are you doing,
Kelly Lynn? But it ain't number 1 on the list. Look at the dunk of the night right here. We used to see Miles Bridges dunk on people. Look at Jalen Brown of the Boston Celtics. And I love Miles Bridges. He's special. But that he got posted.
He
got posterized right there.
Yeah,
you gotta know there's certain things that you gotta know. Don't challenge. Miles Bridges is used to dunking on people. He got caught last night. He got caught.
That back. Looks like you in a 6-foot rim.
Trust me. If there's anybody that'll get the league back on dunks, it's Miles Bridges.
Jay, any disagreement on that order?
No, I got no problem at all.
Okay.
No problem at all.
Nice job.
You right. Okay. Yeah, that's a good list right there. That's it. That's an A-type list.
Take your victory, Lau.
That's an A-list.
That was a good moment for you. You know, Dad talks right Keyshawn, twice a day.
Keyshawn, don't want to give it. He's just holding out.
No, it's cool.
No, right. It's cool.
Other than the last two was, the first two was all right.
No, they were top five of the night.
Yeah, they was all right.
That was cool. They were all right. That's why they weren't top two.
All right.
See what I'm saying?
Let's get to the Lakers.
No, but let's
Some things happen over the weekend. You like us. They unraveled on Friday night. 115-105 loss to Phoenix. The ugliest moment happening when teammates Anthony Davis, Dwight Howard got into a physical altercation on the bench in the second quarter. Magic Johnson tweeting this. Dwight Howard and AD getting into a physical altercation on the bench. In my 42 years of being associated with the Lakers organization, I've never seen something like that. Lakers are 1-2, lost it to the Warriors, the Suns, as I just mentioned, and beating the Grizz by 3 on Sunday. Should the Lakers still be the favorites to win it all, Jay?
You're damn right they should be. Let me give you a Kobe Bryant quote. Everything negative, pressure and challenges, it's all an opportunity for me to rise. Mm-hmm. All these things, guys, veteran teams, people aren't going to like to hear it because we want to see the Lakers come out strong and be that team that dominates people right away. This is like training camp for them, right? They have to work out so many different things with their team defensively, a lot of question marks around it. That whole thing about passion, for me, that conflict is a good sign of growth because that was about miscues on how they guard a screen and roll. And my thing is, I don't want anybody on that team to settle for mediocrity. Mm-hmm. And LeBron James knows. You also saw in that game him talking trash to Cameron Payne. You say, all right, remember, be humble now. So I'm going to bet the house on the fact that guys like Russell Westbrook, he and I talk about it on our show all the time. We as athletes, I'm petty. I'm crazy competitive. I remember everything you do. So all the people lambasting Russell Westbrook, you don't think he's going to remember that? All the people talking trash to LeBron James, you don't think he's going to remember that? People not having Dwight Howard on the top 75 list, you don't think Dwight remembers that? That conflict you saw? These are all things that are going to perpetuate and motivate the Lakers. I don't care about where they start. I care about where they finish.
Okay. Yeah, and I think they still are the team to beat despite this little tit that they had on the sideline. In practice, you can only imagine, Stephen A. and Molly, what goes on in practice. Mm-hmm. The arguments, the pushing and shoving. They're trying to sort things out. Yeah. This won't be the first time. This isn't the first time, and it won't be the last time. It just so happened it was on television. We saw it, and it was like, oh, God, what is going on here? It didn't cost them the game. It didn't cost them their season.
But why was Magic so bothered by it then?
Well, because Magic's been in a situation, like you said, for 42 years. He's never seen that. They handled their confrontation differently when he played.
I've seen a lot of confrontation like that. I mean, I've seen a lot of people go at it. I've worked out with Kobe. I've seen Kobe try to fight. I've seen Michael Jordan try to fight people.
That's not the biggest reason if they were not to advance. That wouldn't be the biggest reason. It would be because their age, they're breaking down, they're not playing defense. That would be the problem, Stephen A.
Let me say this. First of all, the argument was nothing. It was much ado about nothing. Yeah, and if you look at Dwight Howard, when Dwight Howard was going back at him, because he, NBA TV showed the complete footage, and AD had chased D. Howard down and confronted him. All Dwight Howard was saying to him was not on camera.
Yeah.
Not in public. If you look at him and you watch him, he's like, not here.
Yeah,
not,
being a veteran.
In other words,
being
he's like, not here. That's all he was saying. He wasn't having a problem with Anthony Davis, what Anthony Davis was saying. He's saying, you don't come at me like that with the cameras rolling in front of everybody. That's all Dwight Howard was saying. That's number one. Number two, let me say this to you. It wasn't a big deal, but what I'm seeing from the Lakers is a big deal only in this respect. It ain't about Russell Westbrook and questioning him. This brother's a walking triple-double. He's a future Hall of Famer. He made it on my top 75 list. Of course, LeBron did. Of course, AD did. Of course, Carmelo Anthony did. Dwight Howard, no, he'll be my top 100. He wasn't my top 75. That's a subject for another day. But let me tell you something right now. My reservations about the Lakers is my reservations about everybody. I am willing to sit here in front of y'all right now, and I'm telling you right now, the Golden State Warriors might win it all. And I'm telling you this, and let me say, I'm getting to a point where I'm using my imagination, imagining Klay Thompson comes back. Of course, I'm not talking about as presently constructed. Klay Thompson comes back. Wiseman comes back. All right? What I've seen from Jordan Poole, Andrew Wiggins, Damian Lee, Kuminga coming back. You know, they're not coming. You know, he's the first round pick, number 7 overall. I'm looking at this squad, their ability to hit shots. And free throws. And I'm telling you right now, if Klay Thompson and brothers come back healthy, the only thing that will have any chance of stopping them is Kyrie Irving returning to Brooklyn to join Harden and KD. There is no one else, including the Lakers, that will be able to knock off the Golden State Warriors.
See, I push back on you.
That's where I'm at with
that. And I, as a Laker fan, but merely as a basketball fan, because this is a new team and a new nucleus coming together.
Okay.
You've got to give them an opportunity to gel. We just assume Klay Thompson's going to come back as Klay Thompson.
Right.
This brother's had two different surgeries over the last couple of years.
Okay. I want to respond to that, but let me say this to you. A couple of things that you need to pay attention to that I'm bringing up. Number one, I'm assuming the Lakers are going to get it together because I believe in any team led by LeBron James, they eventually will be ready, so long as they're healthy. They eventually will be ready come playoff time. And I believe in Russell Westbrook. I think he gets a bad rap, people calling him selfish or whatever. He might need to make better decisions. But he definitely needs to improve his perimeter shot because they dare him to shoot sometimes. That's problematic for them. And him and LeBron James have both struggled to shoot 70% from the free throw line in the last 3 years. People have ignored that. You got to make free throws come playoff time. That's one element. And number two, it's important, Jay, because you know you're going to get to the line. The game slows down. Defenses get back. More fouls are called. You're going to have to make free throws. We know Golden State ain't missing them. But these guys, they might miss them. Number two, and more importantly, remember when you bring up Klay Thompson's key?
Yes.
If it's Russell Westbrook and he has that kind of injury, it's a disaster. Because his success,
his success
is predicated on his athleticism.
But he still got to play defense.
Thompson. Klay Thompson.
But Klay got to play defense.
Time out. Klay's success is based off his athleticism too. Now,
defensively.
Don't sleep on his athleticism.
I'm not.
Klay Thompson is one of the most athletic dudes there.
Yeah, but I'm just talking about he's such a pure shooter. Is what I'm saying.
Oh, great. So you see him as a pure.
He's not going to lose his shot. Is what I'm saying.
Okay, he probably won't. But he was also one of their biggest clampdown defenders when
it
came to clutch moments.
I agree with that.
And my thing is, when you have you haven't played basketball in 2 years.
Sure.
If you were to sit here and say, next year, I'm like, okay, I hear you on that. Next year, because I actually want to see Klay play for a significant amount of time, not get injured, find his rhythm. I think it's a lot to put on Klay Thompson coming back this year. Left knee, torn ACL.
Twice.
Comes back twice, comes back off that. Torn Achilles in the right leg, that's compensating off another one. I'm not going to sit here and say Klay Thompson is going to be what he was 2.5 years ago before he got hurt defensively. I think that's a huge loss for them.
That's why I brought up the defensive side of it. As a shooter,
I can't say just because Klay Thompson comes back,
if he's healthy,
they're going to be that team.
I'm saying, remember, I brought up Wiseman.
Yes.
All right. I brought up the development of Poole, Lee, Wiggins. I also brought up Kuminga. So I'm looking at all of them, and I'm saying
So you're just discounting Denver?
No.
Because how about when Jamal Murray comes back?
Well,
what about Jamal Murray and Michael Porter?
Here's how I feel. I feel that the Denver Nuggets run into the kryptonite that is the Los Angeles Lakers because the Joker is the key to their success, and the one person that can neutralize him is Anthony Davis. But Anthony Davis, that's a different animal against Golden State because they're perimeter players. And because they're perimeter players and they hurt you from the outside, you don't have to contend with Anthony Davis as much as Denver would right. because your success is predicated on Jokic.
Let's leave it there. Let me get to another topic. Lakers have the best odds to win the West, according to Caesars, and the Warriors are second as
I'm
of right
take
now.
I'm Caesars and go with them.
Okay. You enjoy Caesars.
We can do that now as long as Klay Thompson's still a question.
And a loss to the Celtics, putting up 25-5-9 last night. Meanwhile, another young superstar, Ja Morant, showed out in a three-point loss Sunday to the Lakers, dropping 43-10. Ja was picked second over.